Dear learners, I am Subhash Gaikawad. Today we will discuss the propagation methods adopted for commercial guava cultivation. Availability of quality and genuine planting material is the most important necessity for establishment of guava orchards. Planting material should be procured from reliable sources, government nurseries, agriculture university nurseries. It should be free from insect and diseases. Age of the planting material should not be more than 1 year. Guava can be propagated by seed, tongue layering, ear layering, wedge grafting or tissue culture. Propagation by seed is used for rootstock production, for raising population, for screening at early phases in the breeding program. Let us see these methods in detail. The first one is seedling raising for rootstock. Seedlings can be raised in the nursery bed or in polythene bags. However, raising rootstock in polythene bag is recommended due to better establishment of plants. Rootstock raising in polythene bags is cost effective as it saves labor in weeding, watering, shifting and lifting of the plants from one place to another. For raising seedling, extract fresh seed from the fully matured ripe fruits and wash them thoroughly to remove the pulpy material clinging to the seed. Guava seeds lose their viability in short period after the extraction from the fruit. Therefore, they should be used immediately after extraction. Guava seeds take long time to germinate because of a hard coating over the endocarp. Therefore, it is necessary to soak seed in water for 12 hours. Soaking of seed in water followed by treatment with GA3, that is gibberellic acid, 1000 to 3000 ppm for 2 days improves the germination and seedling growth. For preparation of gibberellic acid solution, mix 1 to 3 grams of gibberellic acid in 1 liter of water. Dip guava seed in copper oxychloride 0.2% solution for 2 minutes before sowing in the raised bed or in polythene bags for the management of the damping of disease which occurs on the seedlings in early stage. Such seeds should be sown in polythene bags filled with soil mixture. After sowing the seed, cover the polythene bags with 100 micron, that is 400 gauge white polythene sheet. Seeds covered with polythene sheet gives as high as 95 to 97% success within 3 weeks. These seedlings become ready in 8 to 12 months for grafting. There is variation in plant propagated through seed, therefore vegetative propagation methods are used in guava. Plants produced through vegetative methods are true to type, early bearer and high yielders. By this method, a large number of plants can be produced in short time with minimum mortality. Tongue layering, ear layering and wedge grafting are the most commonly used vegetative methods in guava. Let us see tongue layering method in detail. Tongue layering is an easy and cheap method of vegetative propagation followed due to its higher success rate. It can be practiced throughout the year. For preparation of tongue layering, select the pencil thickness shoot from healthy mother plants. Trim off the side branches and leaves from this shoot from its base. Do not remove leaves 25 to 30 cm behind the tip. Make a slit on the lower side of the selected shoot using sharp knife. The slit cut should be below the bud node and halfway through the thickness of that shoot. The cut should be extended up to 3 to 4 cm. Due to this slit cut, downward translocation of metabolites manufactured by the leaves is interrupted. This will result in the accumulation of carbohydrates and hormones above the operated portion, that is slit cut, which ultimately stimulate root formation. plant growth regulators like indolbitaric acid, that is IBA 4000-5000 ppm, should be applied immediately on the cut portion with the help of a hairbrush. For preparing IBA solution, mix 4 to 5 grams of IBA in 1 liter of water. This will enhance rooting and survival of the layers. A small piece of stick like toothpick should be inserted to keep apart two sliced portion of slit. This will avoid rejoining or healing of the slit. The earthen pot filled with one part of soil and one part of FOIM should be used to place the operated portion for rooting in soil. Place heavy stone on the operated portion to keep the operated portion intact with the soil. Nowadays, instead of earthen pots, polythene bags are used because of its convenience and cost effectiveness. In this method, there is no need to place stone on operated portion. Rooting on the operated portion will start after 3 weeks. The root proliferation varies with the plant and many other internal factors. Profuse rooting on the tongue layer can be seen within 3 months. The layer will be ready to detach from the mother plant within a period of 3 to 4 months. To avoid immediate shock to the tongue layers, after removing it from the mother plant, it is necessary to give a halfway cut on the mother plant 1 week before actually detaching the tongue layers. Now let us see air layering method of guava propagation. Air layering propagation method is used because of high rooting and survival of 80 to 85% layers. Air layering is practiced during rainy season, that is from June to September. For air layering, 1 year old branches of 1 to 1.5 meter length are selected on the mother plant. A ring of bark from the selected branch should be removed 45 cm away from the tip. The ring width should be 2.5 to 3 cm long. For better rooting, root promoting plant growth hormone, that is indolbitaric acid, IBA, at the rate of 4000 to 5000 ppm is applied at the upper cut end of girdle area. For preparing IBA solution, mix 4 to 5 g of IBA in 1 liter of water. The girdle area is covered with moist sphagnum moss and wrapped with polythene tape. Rooting starts within 3 to 5 weeks. After 6 to 8 weeks, sufficient roots are visible through the transparent polythene tape. Then the air layer is removed from the branch by cutting the stem below the girdle area. The polythene film is removed from the finally severed rooted stem. Some of the top of the branch is headed back. Then the detached air layer is potted in polythene bag and kept in shade until new leaves appears. When the new flush are produced, the plants can be transplanted in the field. Grafting is another method practiced in guava. In grafting, farmers get the advantage of well-developed root system of the rootstock. Due to grafting, dwarfness, disease and stress resistance can be incorporated in grafted plant. Grafting in guava can be done by wedge grafting method. Seedlings are raised for rootstock in the nursery for 6 to 8 months. We have already seen how to raise the seedlings. Select the seedlings having stem diameter of pencil thickness. It should be near 2.5 to 1 cm girth for wedge grafting. This seedling will be used as rootstock. For scion, select 15 to 20 cm long and 3-4 month old shoot. It should be of pencil thickness and have 3-4 healthy buds on it. Selected scion shoots are defoliated on the mother plant about a week prior to detaching. And at the same time, the apical growing portion of selected scion shoot is also beheaded. This helps in forcing the dormant bud to swell. After selection of the scion, rootstock seedling is headed back by retaining 15 to 20 cm long stem above the soil level in the polythene bag. The beheaded rootstock is split to about 4 to 4.5 cm deep through the center of the stem with grafting knife. a wedge shape cut 4 to 4.5 cm long, slanting from both the sides, is made on the lower side of the cyan shoot. The cyan stick is then inserted into the split of the stalk and pressed properly so that cambium tissue of rootstock and cyan stick should come in contact with each other. Here we should have to take care to match the cambium layers of the stalk and cyan along with full length of each component. The graft union is then tied with the help of 150 gauge polythene strip. Immediately after grafting, the graft is covered by long white polythene cap which is tied with a rubber band at the lower end. The cyan starts sprouting after 10 to 12 days. The cap on the graft is removed after 25 days in the evening hour. The grafts are transferred to net house for hardening. Thank you.